That's right. You see it. There is red markings on my new Travis Scott 4s from Hype Mariner. I ain't gonna lie, I was in a total state of shock when I opened the box and seen this. I was live recording the unboxing. I just stood there and stared like, I can't believe this is happening. So I immediately stopped the recording and I reached out to them. And to my surprise, they got to me within a couple of minutes. So let's back up here and let's look at their website first. I was going to turn this into another, is this the best UA site to purchase from? But that has obviously changed. So let's go ahead and just look at the website. So first of all, if you look at their website, the website is beautiful. So I was really excited about making them a review video for free. Free of charge. There's no promotion or any compensation here. I bought my own shoes, and I think where I went wrong was trying to purchase a pair of Kobe's. I will never try to purchase a pair of Kobe's from a UA site or any site. I bought the Kobe's close to when Kobe actually made his transition or passed, and they had a really good discount going on, so I purchased these Kobe 4 Protro Draft Day Hornets, and I was going to do a performance review and everything. I was so hyped up. Again, beautiful website, but let's pause this for a second and let's look at some messages and emails. Okay, so on the first message receipt I have here, I'm asking them, just giving them a heat check. I'm saying, do the Kobe's have Zoom units in them? Because the ProTro is supposed to have Zoom units, and I don't know if these companies are using legit units or not. So they're saying, yes, same as OG. We got the 101, UA sneaker, all that good stuff I like to hear. Then some time goes by, I'm like, hello, I was looking for the shipment. Basically, where are they at? Then they're basically saying, you know, with the situation going on, there are people out of work, and you can see they're talking about they'll be back in February 20th. And by the way, this is all good. This is totally okay. I totally understand. I responded back, thank you, God bless. There is nothing wrong with the current situation going on. I totally get it. No problems at all. They're even saying they're going to send me a free t-shirt when they do send them. Again, everything's all to the good. So some time passes after that email, then I get another email, and by the way, I'm getting other packages from other UA and replica sellers left and right, no problems, even with the current situation going on. So I get another email. So the message says, and I know you guys can probably read, but basically it's saying, Mr. Cola Culture, the Kobe that you want is not available. They sent me some screenshots of some of the Kobe's that were available. I didn't like the colorways. I wanted the draft days. So I thought about it and I said, let's change gears here. And they even offered something more than the Kobe's. The Kobe's were 170. They said, hey, even 180 will work. So again, at this point, I'm not trying to disparage them. Excellent customer service at this point. So let's keep going. So then I ask him, I say, hey, can I get the Jordan 4 Cactus Jacks? And he said, yes, no problem. And the Cactus Jacks are even 190. So once again, excellent customer service at this point. No complaints. Okay, in this clip right here, this is an actual video sent from Hype Mariner showing quality control. This is very funny here. It's showing quality control of the shoes. He's got them in hand. He's showing me the eyelets. He's showing me everything, the tabs. Everything looks good from the video that he sent me, the sizing. Everything is sweet right here. And heck, I haven't had a UA company or any sneaker company send me actual videos of the shoes. I get pictures. I get several pictures from companies, like 7 pictures saying, hey, here's the sneakers. Here's what they look like. And pictures are great, but a video is even better. But I'm going to let this video play all the way through. It's like a minute. I'm going to let them play through just so I can show you guys both sides of the story so you can determine if I'm just freaking out. Am I overreacting? Because again, I didn't say that they have bad customer service. Customer service is probably their strongest point. So if you have any issues with this company, they will answer you in a timely manner for sure. So everything looked good. I didn't pay attention to that suspect toe box right there. And there's more on this toe box coming soon, but let's keep going. But at this point, all of us can see there are, from what I can tell from this video, there's no red markings on the shoe yet. So back to me on the unboxing day. After I seen that red on the shoe, all I could see was red after that. I went blank. So I sent them these 4 pictures kind of give an idea of what I'm seeing right here on the spot. All I did was open the box. You guys seen me open the box. I didn't even do anything to these sneakers. Like, why would I mess these sneakers up? So I'm like, hey, what can we do? I actually have a message. Let's look at the message. So right there, you can see, I'm like, hey, they came with markings on them. Tear emoji. And I almost did shed a tear right when I saw those red markings. And then I'm like, is there anything we can do about this? I want to make a great video. And all this great stuff I had in my head that I was going to do is not happening. And then they're pretty much like, sorry for the unclear parts. I'm like, okay. And then there was a little discrepancy about the sizing that I wanted. I really wanted a 9.5, but I guess it was a 10. I know there's somewhere I asked him for a 9.5, but that's beside the point. And then I'm telling him, like, hey, I didn't get the Supreme tee that you said you were going to give me in the email, which it did arrive. It just looked a little weird, and I was skeptical about opening it because the package looked kind of weird. So I didn't even know it was a t-shirt. They didn't even tell me or send me pictures or a video of the t-shirt. They just kind of threw it in there. So, and you can see in the message, I came clean a couple hours later and told him, yes, I did get the tee. Right there is another, I don't know if that's a watermarking or a scuff or something from the box again, I'm not sure, but that's just, you know, that's quality control, to be honest. For the price you pay for these type of sneakers that are quote unquote unauthorized authentics, I mean, I'm getting better stuff from other companies, to be quite honest with you. And the color of the blue sole towards the bottom, that Carolina blue color, I don't know if that's the correct color that goes with these shoes. It looks a little off, and it looks a little too Carolina bluish to me. Now, the worst part to me really is this toe box. Now, look at that toe box, guys. And you know what Jordan's toe boxes crease, especially through like 1 through freaking 6. They all crease. And how am I going to get a shoe in the box that's already, come on now, just, it's already creased. I haven't even worn it yet. It's creased. So please, guys, audience that's watching, comment below heavily. Tell me, am I being a big baby? Am I overreacting? Am I being too picky? I mean, you drop 170 or wherever it was at this point. It was over $150, so that's just a lot of money. And to get something, I've been getting better products from other sellers with crappy looking websites, and they had a beautiful website. So I was feeling really good and confident about this purchase. Hype Mariner, if you're watching, you gotta make this right. A t-shirt is not gonna fix this. They said they send me another t-shirt in the next order, and I'm thinking, who's going to be paying for this next order? Not me. So, you know, it left a bad taste. And, you know, look right there, the Travis Scott stitching under the tongue, it doesn't look that great. It just doesn't. It's the stitching's off. That's easy to spot. No one's going to be looking behind your tongue, but still, it's off. Here's a look at the other shoe. And at this point, guys, I sucked it up. I cleaned them. He asked me in the message, do I have a dry, I'm not putting a dry eraser on these. So I took a dry microfiber cloth and I cleaned these off as best as I could. You can still see some markings right there, but I tried to clean these off as best as I could just to do this unboxing right here. I mean, I don't know. You guys tell me. I need the people to speak up on this one. You guys tell me. All right, let's just get through this unboxing. It has nice stitching on the Jordan, on the tongue. Air Jordan behind the, I think that's the right shoe. And the inside, it says Cactus Jack, and the other one just says Air Jordan. It has nice, clear little pods there. That is a nice touch. That was really nice. It's got Cactus Jack on the back. That looks really great. No complaints there. Right here, I noticed another little blemish, but, you know, whatever. So, and here's a little flip tag. And, you know, you can tell I'm not even reviewing this the way I usually would, with a lot of love, because, to be quite frankly, I'm upset. You know what I'm saying? I'm upset. Here's a quick look at the box. It has the tag on it. It says 190, but it's not flippy. But whatever. Doesn't need to flip. At least it's there. Jordan 4 Retro. I'm not sure if the retail box just says Jordan 4, if it says, like, Jordan 4 Travis, like the Off-White ones do. And here's the shirt. So the shirt was in that green packaging. This is supposed to be the San Francisco shirt. And this thing actually goes for like 300 plus on StockX. I was like, what? It says Made in USA. I'm not even going to say nothing about that. but it's kind of orangish. It actually looks pretty cool. I'm not sure about the cotton quality, but it says a beautiful place with beautiful people. So all the beautiful people out there, go ahead and like this video because it really helps your boy out. All right, to end this on a positive note, I went to Walmart to get some survival necessities and I decided let's kill two birds with one stone and do the on feet inside of Walmart. Isn't that a great idea? So you see me creasing them, which really doesn't matter because that shoe is already creased. And Walmart actually has pretty decent lighting. Like no matter where you go inside Walmart, the lighting is pretty good. So I walked around, checked out what is not there in the stores. I pretty much went to go get water. We got plenty of food. Shout out to everybody in the entire world, Italy, China, United States, anybody that's going through what we're going through right now. You know, much love. Make sure you hit up the stores. It really wasn't that bad today. But anyway, try to pick a couple spots to get some shots. As you can see, it's actually not that busy in Walmart. But, you know, I may do what I could make do with. As content creators, sometimes we got to do stuff like this. You might have to do a freaking unboxing outside. You might have to do an on feet inside of a store or on the side of a house or in an alley. That's just part of the game. But anyway, the shoes are actually pretty freaking comfortable. I know I noted I wanted a 9.5, but this 10 actually fits perfect. I'm wearing sort of a thicker sock, but they feel pretty good as far as comfort, and that's always high on the list. They got to be comfortable. They came pre-creased, so I guess that's, you know, that's part of it as well. I know, and don't get me wrong, I know shoes are going to crease when you walk. You're walking in the creasing motion at all times, so I know they're going to crease, but I just wanted Hype Mariner to make it right. And on IG, they go by Pulp Sneaker. Really great people over there, which shocks me that I get something that looks this way. And granted, the box may have been old. The red inside that box may have rubbed up on the sneakers throughout the shipping and all of that. But as a company that sells products like this, you have to make it right. You can't have a great customer service on the internet, but then when it comes to quality control, you can't have an unsatisfied customer. I was extra excited about making a video and talking about promoting the site and all this stuff for them. And this is what I get. I wanted to hear, Mr. Cola Culture, we're going to get you another pair of Travis Scott 4s. That's what I should have heard, because I'm doing them such a service by making this video. So that's all I got. I'm done crying about this. Like, subscribe. Peace out, guys. I'll catch you on the next one.